letter in the mail, the American Heritage letter.
This video also has a very special giveaway for a Heritage letter, an entire year, 12 letters. Also a special thank you to Jennifer from Family of Three Homeschool. This is such a lovely collab, and this playlist is in the description box below. Welcome.
What's it a picture of?
Mayflower.
The Mayflower. I'm here with my son, and he loves history, and he definitely enjoys learning more about it. So here we got a postcard. Now, we live so close to this in Maine. We're about 3.5 hours.
Oh, yeah.
Plymouth Plantation and all of those things in Plymouth Rock. And we seriously want to go and do this, and this is going to go ahead and spark our excitement for it. So this letter was sent to us by the American Heritage Letters, History Letters. Oh, and we're so thankful to take part in this collaboration. This collaboration has got 12 YouTube homeschool mamas that are working together, and we get to review this letter, and it's already sparked a little bit of excitement in learning here in our homeschool, as you can see. So we're gonna look through this letter together, and we're gonna add some fun and adventure to this homeschool day.
For those of you who know me well, I was a high school trained history teacher and business education major turned homeschool mama. So this is my thing. The Pilgrims first left England and went over to Holland. We know the Pilgrims came over from Holland, and the reason they left was because the children were, end quote, in great licentiousness, meaning they were learning bad things from the Dutch youth. They were in prosperity there. There was no persecution. Unlike the persecution they experienced in England, Puritans were doing well, but they still got on that boat and they came here in 1620. And I am so very thankful that they did. They came for liberty. They came for God, to serve him the way that they chose, freedom of religion, and also economic reasons.
All right, so what does that say?
Do I have to read all of it?
No, we'll read it together, but here's Plymouth. See how they used to spell things differently? Now they spell with a Y, Plymouth.
When first pulling out your letter, you get a beautiful little postcard. You can write your friend back that wrote to you, or write another friend. We might write a family member. And over here, we have the beginning of our letter written to us. Beautiful pictures from Lizzie Jane. So beautiful. Starts out here, Winnesuick, friends. That's Wampanoag word for good day. And it's pronounced Wa-ni-ki-suk. Of course, I totally ruined it. I'm off to a grand adventure in here in Plymouth, Massachusetts. Here I'm learning all about the Pilgrims and the Wampanoag, the native people who lived in the region where the Pilgrims landed. The year 2020 marks the 400th anniversary of the Pilgrims' voyage. Okay, we have to celebrate with a prize. And because we're the history buffs that we are, we already have our commemorative mugs sent to us from Grandma. So you see Plymouth Rock there. Plymouth Rock, 1620 to 2020. We got all of the beautiful monuments and places you can visit there in Massachusetts. Here's also the same celebration of the first Thanksgiving, 400 years of a family tradition, 1621 to 2021. So we got both of these. I know that's a bit extra, but we absolutely love our history. All right, back to the letter now. Voyage on board the Mayflower from England to the New World. I couldn't think of a better way to celebrate than in person. How exciting.
Look, there's some Native American language here. Winnekeswick. How would you say that? Winnekeswick. Friends, that's one word for good day. Isn't that cool? Now, what I know as a history buff is, as far as I understand,
Pilgrim.
So, our founding fathers came over right? They spent lots of time in another country, and then they came over on a vessel called the
Mayflower.
The Mayflower. Now, the Mayflower
was not the only ship. Did you know that there were two ships? One was called the Speedwell. The Speedwell, I liked to teach my students that it was not speed and it was not well. It actually had to be abandoned and they had to go back to get it fixed. That cut down the number of people coming over on the Mayflower. So they truly were pilgrims. They truly were going into a land with the drive that God has given them to pursue peace, to love God, and to create a new colony and a new way of life.
Now the Mayflower was a ship. A lot of this is coming to mind, so it's unrehearsed. Most of a homeschool day, it's not rehearsed, not really, studied, but sometimes things just come up. So the Mayflower was a ship that was hired. Do you know, like, taxi? Kind of what the Mayflower was. The Mayflower was a pirate ship, and they kept a log of all the places it went, and all the crew that it carried, and so on and so forth, all the shipping. Actually, when the Mayflower got there and got the pilgrims off, they went ahead and fixed the ship quite a bit, and they sent back stuff and some people.
Pilgrims.
Went back. Anyways, so it was a tough journey, and it was a hired ship. So, do you want to hear something else about the Mayflower? Nothing else in there, but this is exciting. We have some books that we want to go through to add to this. Look at this. Plymouth Patuxet has a living history museum. So, this is written by the little girl that went ahead and explored this area, and she wrote you a letter. Isn't that nice? Do you want to read some of it? I'm off to a grand adventure in Plymouth, Massachusetts. Is that where Grandma and Grandpa live?
And Uncle Ed.
And Uncle Egg, all of our friends, all of our family. I'm here learning about the pilgrims and the Wampanoag. Remember what Wampanoag was? Is it the Native Americans, the Indians that lived there? Yeah. Do you remember the number that was on the rock when they landed?
Nope.
Do you remember?
They didn't land, they crashed.
They didn't land, they crashed. Well, they kind of crashed because we've talked about this quite a bit. The ship was completely battered and it struggled. They actually had to take one of the printing press augs that they had, the corkscrew press that they had, and they had to shore up the ship with it. Sorry, an ant was crawling on me because we're outside. So they had to shore up the ship with that printing press aug or thing. All this is coming to mind. It's crazy how history just comes back. I'm going to put some books in the description box, books that I enjoy to read and all that. And of course, what's really fun to read is the originals. Do you remember the governor of Massachusetts? The governor there?
Mm-hmm.
The original governor passed away, but William Bradford took over and some others after that. But William Bradford wrote a history even when he wasn't in charge, called Of Plymouth Plantation, and going back to the original source for things is amazing. You get to learn about the Native Americans that were very influential in the beginning of there. Squanto, a lot of people know about him, and so on. Who was the other guy? Squanto and
Tiger.
Oh no, Tiger is in your book that you're reading, but that's good to see the relationships of what they're learning now and how they're understanding the world around them. So learning is happening. So anyway, we are so thankful for getting this letter. It has really sparked a discussion. It has been exciting for myself and my son, and my younger ones are in resting, but they're gonna think it's really fun too. Look, we got a wonderful history adventure letter in the mail. Would you like to go to Plymouth Plantation once things open up? Would you like to see Plymouth Rock? And there is a replica there at Plymouth Harbor. I grew up near there. Now we live in Maine, and I've already said that, but where I grew up at. We go there a lot. The ship that is there is a replica, obviously. It is not the original, and even if it said a little bit ago, there was a problem on its way back. It got lost and caught off the record, so they don't know what really happened to it. It could have been shipwrecked or what have you, but the excitement that the Mayflower brought our founding fathers over to this land so that we could have this beautiful country we have now. They came over for liberty, freedom of religion, and just to be able to serve God in the way that they chose, and they were able to do that. That's why we have the freedoms that we have today, and I thank God for them. I thank God for their stand in following the Bible and what they believed to be true when it came to serving God and doing right. So I'm thankful, and I am so thankful for this letter. Thank you for sending it to us. Woo! Brave women from different cultures that shaped our nation. The importance of history in our culture. The importance of history to be taught to our children. So thank you for joining us. There's a couple other things that I want you to be aware of is that we a Rafflecopter that we are putting on. So these small channels are all reviewing the letter, and we were graciously given it to us by our host, the creator and curator of these wonderful letters. So thank you so much for giving these things to us. It's been a blessing already, and we are going to continue to use it and go on adventures to see and do the things that we have read about. Anyway, the Rafflecopter in the description box below, you want to get into that because there's going to be one winner that is going to win 12 letters, meaning one for every month of the year. So you get to win that and you get to go ahead and take part in having some adventures in your homeschool. So I hope that you can join in on that. Don't forget to check out the playlist below and the different letters and different YouTube mamas and homeschool ladies that are going to take part. And yes, we are so thankful we got this. We can send that to someone because it's a postcard. So there's a lot of beautiful things that you can get to add to your homeschool adventure life. So this is one of them. So check her out. Check out the Rafflecopter. Also check out, go ahead and get this for somebody. Maybe you're a mom or a homeschool Grammy or someone, and you have people in your life that you want to add adventure to historically. Go ahead and get onto that. Order it for someone, gift it to a homeschool mama that needs a little help. We all do. And just thank you so much for watching Mind Your Matters. We mind our matters so that we have more time for what matters, which is loving Jesus, loving God, and serving others. So thank you so much. And we're going to enjoy the rest of this letter together. You want to read all about the Wampanoag Indians and the Pilgrims and all the things that happened with the Mayflower? I can't wait. So thank you, and I hope that you have a wonderful day. And that you enjoyed my son putting postcards in the camera. Say bye. Oh, like, subscribe, and share.
Bye.
Bye. See you next time. To the bread.